Hey everybody, my name is Kevin Moore. Welcome back for another video of NHL 21 Franchise Mode. We're going to continue this series. As you can see, we're about to start off the regular season. I think this is going to be our fourth season, right? What year are we? 2023? I think it's our fourth season. Yeah, I'm pretty sure at least. So we're about to start it up. I had a really good season last year. Not only did we finish very first in the division, in the entire league, so we won the President's Trophy, we actually won the Stanley Cup itself as well, boys. So we went all the way and we won it all. So now that we got the cup, I did exactly what I wanted to do with this team. All we have to focus on is try and win as many more as possible, boys. And get this team up and going as much as possible. This franchise already has got its limits. So we're good on that part. Only 3 years done and already the cup. So all we need to do is focus on the future now. We've got Boudin, Kako still, Lafreniere. We got a lot of prospects. And we've got the veterans like Malkin and Staal. All these guys helping out, right? So I think my lineups were already done. So we can keep it moving. We can start simulating right away, boys. We don't need to waste any time here. We're going to simulate the first 10 games, of course, like the usual stuff. And see where this is going to lead us. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. So all the way up to the Calgary Flames game right there. So we simulate almost an entire month right here. First 10 games. Let's see where this is going to lead us, boys. Last year, we had a fantastic season. Let's hope that this season is going to be the same. We start off with two losses in shootout and overtime. And another and a loss in regulation against the Panthers right there. Not good, boys. Montreal, we lose against them. So that's four losses in a row right there. Something's not doesn't add up, boys, right there. We're losing games. We haven't won a single game yet. There we go. There's finally a win. The hell's going on here? We're getting points, bonus points. But we got to get those wins. There we go. Get back in this shit, boys. Win those games. We started off pretty rough right there. Can we? Oh, God. Another regulation loss. Am I going to have to make some changes here for the lineups? Oh, I guess so, boys. I guess my strategy from last year is not working this year. That's not normal. It's not working this year. I don't know why it's not, boys. What the hell's going on here? I do see Malkin being our best player. Is there a problem here with the first line? How come does this not work right here? What the fuck is happening? What is this, boys? I thought it was supposed to work. Isn't it? I'm pretty sure it's supposed to work. 90 awareness. 89. Do I really have to? Like, this is ridiculous. This doesn't make any sense, boys, to me. This really doesn't make any sense right now. This should not be a problem. Is it because Rackles should be playing with these guys instead? Like, what's going on here? I have absolutely no idea as to what's going on right now. This is, I'm clueless. Maybe I gotta bring up the old lines again or something. Yeah, this is not good. What the hell? All my players are not doing good, boys. Do I really need to change it already? Like, I thought everything was good. Look at the plus three, plus ones. This is the same strategy. I've got the same setup as last year. It's somehow, it's not working out. It's not Shesterkin. He's doing good. Yeah, I don't know. Let me check that out. All right, let's try it that way, boys. So I made it so that there's two playmakers and a sniper for each line. So sniper and Panarin. Afterwards, it's two playmakers for the first line. Let's see if that works out for us. I guess Kako's going back to the first line, boys. Maybe that's going to help them out. Lafreniere with Ryan Strom and Kasha, so they have a sniper to play with now. Olofsson, sniper, playing with the two playmakers and Rackle and Staal. And there we go, two playmakers right here playing with a sniper and Boudin. Let's see if that's going to work out, boys. Maybe that's the difference. Maybe that's what I was supposed to be doing, I guess. The combination, right? Maybe that wasn't working out. So we'll see if that little change by itself is going to... it's going to be enough right here to help out our team. So 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. So all the way up to the Washington Capitals game. We're going to be at 20 games right there. Let's see what happens right here. Okay, there's a loss in regulation again. So far, nothing. Derek Holder's a win against Ottawa Senators. Can we get some winning streak going or something? This is garbage. What the hell's going on with my team, boys? I have the same team as last year. I have got a better roster, I would imagine, right? There we go. There's some wins. I mean, I'm supposed to win right there. What the fuck is going on? I think EA's messing with me, boys, big time. This is not normal. This is not normal. I've got the same roster as last year, the same strategies, and it's not working out for some reason. I think EA is just voodooing me right now, big time. What the hell? All right. Another loss in regulation. 7-0. 7-1. Like, one goal, really. And another loss in shootout against New Jersey. That is not good. Really not good, boys. Okay, so now we're 5-4 and 1. Better than last one. Than the last thing, but... Still, boys, this is rough. We're the worst team, one of the worst teams of the leagues, but the worst team of our division. This is not good. How the fuck is this happening right now? What the hell's going on with our team? We gotta look at team stats, boys. Something doesn't add up right there. Something doesn't work at all. Rangers, we've got the worst offensive team. That's not good. We've got the second worst penal defensive team as well. What the fuck's going on here? That's the 5-on-5, boys. Power play? Where's my power? I've got the worst power play. And our 20th team in terms of penalty kill. So we're fine in penalty kill. But we got the worst goddamn power play. And we've got one of the worst 5-on-5s. What the fuck are we supposed to do at this point, boys? Are we completely lost here? What just happened? What literally just happened right here? And how is there -7? This doesn't make any goddamn sense, boys. I'm completely clueless. Am I gonna just have to throw it to the sea or something? I don't know. What the fuck is this? How are they -11 and stuff? The fourth line's working. I don't know. I have no idea what's going on, boys. I am clueless right now. This is not good. This is not good at all. This is really not... I don't like this. Buffalgun, Klingberg, Miller. How is this -17 and -12? What the fuck? Do I need a defensive defenseman all of a sudden? Like, what is this? How are you playing so bad? So bad, my guy. What the fuck? Oh, this is horrible. This is horrible right here. This is what I like to call bullshit. Alright, you know what? He's +7. You're -12. You're going down. You're -2. You're going down. Giordano on the first line. I don't give a shit anymore. I'm just playing the guys that I play the best. I'm playing them more. You're going to stay there. Yeah. I need to penalize somebody. I'm going to penalize Miller right here. And between these two guys weren't doing too good. Oh my god, I don't know what to do, boys. I gotta keep Klimbert in here. I gotta be honest, I gotta keep him in here. He's a exact top six. Alright, here's the new lineup, boys. For the next three stuff. I'm also gonna change the strategies around. We'll see if anything works out. We gotta change the strategies because we got the worst offensive team, boys. I don't know what to do. Panarin, Malkin, and Kasha together. We're bringing them back together. Seems like the only option. I'm looking at Poise now, boys. I'm just going to look at Poise. Now, if I put him like that, it would be a +5 for the second line. But I'm going to try that way instead right here. Olofsson with Ryan Strom and Rackle on the second line. Teravainen with Johansson and Kako, boys. And Lafreniere right here playing with Stahl and Boudin, boys. This is the only thing I see right here. Lafreniere is going to be put on the fourth line. I don't know what to do. I could play him on the... keep playing on the second line and stuff. But, I mean, what the hell am I supposed to do at this point? Let's just keep him on the second line, actually. I got to keep him on the second line. I mean, he's supposed to be a second liner right now. That's where I got it set up. So, he's supposed to play there. The problem is with these two guys, man. I mean... Jesus, this is rough, boys. Olofsson's better than Teravainen. These guys are on the same par, so I'm going to keep it as it is right here. And these guys are all on the same par, so keep it as it is. So we'll try that one out right here, boys. But, like, what more can I do right here? Literally, what more can I do? I am completely clueless at this point. This got to stay like that. This has to stay like that. This is the only way. I could pray, like, the difference between Giordano, I guess, and Miller. Yeah, I guess that's it. So maybe Giordano right here and Miller on this on the third duo instead. And that's all I can do. That's the only change I can do right here. The rest, I can't really do anything unless I change Barry for Trouba. Maybe, I think, yeah, maybe that's it. All right, so let's just do that. Okay, that's what we're going to do, boys. That's the only thing I can see we can do right now. Next thing, we're going to have to change the strategies up real quick as well. So edit the strategies. It doesn't seem like it's working out for us. We might be a little bit too aggressive right here. Offensive pressure. Let's keep it like that. I want to keep these two things together. But what we're going to do here is full attack. We're going to do aggressive. We're going to pull back up. And puck side attack, we might be a little bit too aggressive. So maybe normal and aggressive. Normal and aggressive, boys. We'll see if that's working out for us. Defensive strategy, collapsing. I got to keep that way. Penalty kill, everything else. Power play is absolutely garbage. So what I might want to do is try something out, something else. So maybe shooting. We're going to try shooting, I guess, on the power play, boys. And let's go. Let's do our thing. I don't know why we're struggling so much. This is a mystery to me. We'll find out, though, if my strategies, new strategies and lines are going to work. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. So all the way up to the Vancouver Canucks game. Can we have a momentum shift right here? Can we bounce back up? There's a win against the Washington Capitals. Just need to bounce back up above 500 right there. There we go. Our second win in a row against the Pittsburgh Penguins. We shut it down a little bit. Oh, there's a loss. Not again, boys. Getting some flashback right here. There we go. There's a win against Toronto. We got to just get more wins than games. More wins than losses. That's all we got to do. I mean, it's not difficult to be in the playoffs because of the divisions we're in. We're in the weakest division. So it's not difficult for us to make it to the playoffs. We just got to win games. There we go. Now we're getting a little bit of a winning streak going right there. I think I did the right thing, boys. I might have figured out the new settings or something. I don't know. But it seems like it's working out for us right now. We're winning games. Panarin's injured at the worst time possible. We're starting to win games. Panarin goes and injures himself. God damn it, boys. Buzhnevich is going to have to replace him, it looks like. So Buzhnevich, you're a top six. You don't belong in here. I'm going to have to put Lafreniere in the first line, boys. I'm going to have to put these guys right here. Yeah, it seems like it. Let me check really quick. Yeah, that's how it works. So Buzhnevich, you're going to have to play on the fourth line. Special units. And I'm going to have to put Buzhnevich in there, boys, as the replacement. He's going to have to play on that part right there. Now, I don't like the fact that this is a thing right here, but we're going to have to keep it like that for now. I don't really care too much. Four-man penalty kill. Somehow, Panarin was playing everywhere, boys. God damn, he was literally playing everywhere. Okay, so extras. We've got 3-on-3, of course. Buzhnevich, you're coming in there. You're the replacement, so you're doing all of this shit. You're the one dealing with all of this. All right, buddy. Make us proud. Last game before the stop. All right, 3-1 loss. So we went a little bit of a wing streak right here, so that's good. We finished up the last record of 10 games with 8-2, so we bounced back up, boys. Lafreniere on the second line is actually doing pretty good. 29 points in 30 games played, so we're keeping him in there. He's actually playing on the first line now that Panarin is injured. And we bounce back up from the worst of the division to fifth place, just like that. We're 34 points. I'm telling you, boys, it's not difficult to be in the playoffs with the division we're in. All right, it's not difficult at all. So we just got to keep winning games, I guess. It's pretty easy to make it in. Let's go, boys. I mean, we won the cup last year. There's no reason. And we were literally the best team of the league as well. There's no reason as to why we're struggling like that. It looks like our goals per game, is it going up? I mean, we're not the worst team anymore. So I don't know if it's actually going up or not, boys. It might be. I think it's going up. And goals against. Goals against. Let's see right here. It's trending down. Good, good, good. That's perfect. All right. So it's all going in the right direction here. Power play. Where is it? Oh, okay. Well, power play, I think it was the worst power play. It's going up, I think. I think everything's going up, boys. We had 71 though, so it's at 75. So everything's going up. Everything's good. Good. Let's just keep it moving, boys. I think we're good for the settings for right now, at least. We're just gonna keep simulating. Hope that Panarin. I just hope that Panarin's gonna come back soon. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. So all the way up to the next month of January, New Year, basically, against the Boston Bruins. We gotta win some games here. Damn it. There's a regulation loss against Vancouver. Can we win games, please? There we go. 8-0 loss win against Montreal. We got another injury. Bufflegun gets injured now. So we lost a defenseman. Our best D-man. One of our best D-mans. And Hunt's going to have to get in there. Replace him. We're going to have to deal with that. So you, I guess, are going to be playing there, boys. That's just how it's going to work. All right, buddy. Let's go. I think poise has a lot to do with how the players play, probably. Maybe it helps out the teams a lot. There we go. There's 3 wins in a row right here. Can we keep it going? There's a couple of players right there that are back. Hold on. Is it Panarin that's back? Or is it everybody? Okay, Bufflegun's not quite ready yet. We're going to wait on him to be fully ready. What did Buzhnevich do for us? 4 points, 2 goals in 5 games played. He played fantastic on the fourth line, boys. He played real great for us. So there we go, buddy. Good job, good job. All right, let's get Panarin back on the first line right here. Let's go. Can we win against Winnipeg? We sure can. We won against them, boys. All right, Bufflegun is officially ready to return now. Let's take a look at Hunt. He did pretty good for us for the simulation, so that's good. We're going to go the right D because Bufflegun's a right D playing on the left D, which Bufflegun originally was, if you remember properly, boys, he was a forward back in the day, boys. Back in the day, he was actually a forward, just like Brent Burns as well. A lot of these, there's a couple of these defensemen, like big-time stud defensemen that were previously forwards, they just went into defense. They got switched to defense and stayed in there for the rest of their career, basically. So there's a loss against Philadelphia, but we got a win against Washington. We're getting some wins right here. And our main goaltender just got injured as well. We're getting hit with the injuries today, boys. Not good at all. At least we're starting to win games now. So that's the good part of it. We're going to have to bring up Malik. Right here, let's go back to edit lines. We're going to have to switch that up, boys. Not going to be an easy video to deal with right here. I already saw Malkin as 89 overall as well. So he dropped to in his overall. That's not good. Hopefully, Holby can hold it in there. He doesn't seem like he's having a good year, boys. So I hope he can bring it back up there by being the main starter for a while. I really hope so because we're going to need him right now. We're going to need him. Shesterkin was helping us out. There we go. There's a win against Montreal, 4-1. And Buffalo, can we win against them? Did we win? I don't know if we won or not, boys. Let's take a... Yeah, we won against Buffalo. Good. There we go. So the last 10 games, we've got a simulation of 8-2 once again, boys. And Lafreniere is now 41 points in 40 games played. Our best player of the team right here. Good. There we go. 50 points. Actually, we might be in the toughest division all of a sudden. I think we might be in the toughest division after all, boys. I don't know. Because we had like two great simulations in a row right here. And for some reason, I don't know. The teams in front of us are keeping up with us. That is not good. It's not a good sign, man. You gotta catch a break right here. We're dominating. Come on. All right, so let's see right here. Are we going up? Are we going up in terms of Rangers? There we go. We're going up big time. We're third best team now. And yeah, that's perfect. There we go. Everything's going up, boys. Power play is going up and everything. Penalty kill. Yeah, everything's trending up. So I changed the strategies up. and I changed the lineups up a little bit, boys, and everything worked out for us. Just to say, boys, when it doesn't work, just switch it around. Just figure something out to switch it around. That's why I'm the best GM out there. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. And there we go. So all the way up to the Carolina game, Hurricanes game. We're going to be at 50, boys. We have the season done right now. And I feel like my team is bouncing back up a little bit. They had a horrible start to the season. But, you know, if they can bounce back up and have a good little rest of the season, we should be all right. There we go. There's two losses and two wins. And there's a win against Buffalo. I like to see that. As long as we keep it up, boys, as long as we get more wins than we get losses, we're going to be just fine. We're going to be able to bounce back up and get these easy streak going on. I just want to make it to the playoffs. The main thing to do is definitely make it to the playoffs, especially since we literally won the cup last year. So if we are the defending Stanley Cup champions, we got to be able to play like such a team, you know? So there's going to be two losses in a row right here. Shesterkin's finally gonna be back. That's probably gonna help us tremendously, because I don't know what Holtby did. He played better ever since he went to starter mode, but I don't know. I feel like he's still not having a great year. I don't know why, but the backups, for some reason, are having a really tough time in this game, boys. Backups in my universe are not too good. We're having a really tough one. All right, let's bring Malik back in there for his lineup and stuff. Bring him in back into the minors. Play him in there. So there we go, buddy. Oh, you go in. Come on. There we go. You go in. What did he do? Okay. He's doing all right, AHL-wise. All right. Come on, boys. I'm not going to make any trades right here for Montreal. Not happening right now. Let's go. Let's get to the Hurricanes game right there. Up and safe right here. So there we go. After the All-Star break. Let's see what where we are in terms of the last simulation. We had a record of 5-4-1, so not too good. Not as good as I would have hoped. I think it's the main difference is because Holtby played throughout the entirety of it. That's the main difference between a good and a bad goaltender, boys. But we're still fourth, so we're moving up in our division. We're still fourth over right there. We should have probably, we could have had a couple more wins. For Shesterkin instead of Holtby, but you know, we're gonna have to do with what we got. 48 points for 50 games played for Lafreniere right there, so he's doing all right. 17 goals, he's having by far his best season of his career right now, so that is good on our part. What about Panarin? He's having a bad season, boys. He's having a really bad season, and that's very unlike him. He had a really good season the entire time with us, and all of a sudden, I don't know why, it's not working out. Him and Malkin together, I guess it's not working out. Maybe it's Kasha, the effect. I don't know what to do, but I'm not going to switch it up because we're winning games, and as long as we're winning games, I'm happy, boys. Not switching anything. Everything's trending up as well. What about Boudin, our main prospect? 16 goals in 50 games played, boys. He's a damn scorer. He doesn't pass the puck, boys. He just scores the That's all he does. He scores goals. So that's fantastic, man. For a guy like this that scores goals, might want to look into the advanced statistic for that one, boys, if he starts doing that. All right. Well, let's take a look. We don't have to really do anything else. What we're going to do is we're going to continue simulation. Now that we got Shesterkin back, we should be all right. 2-4. 6 against Columbus Blue Jackets, 8 and 10, so all the way up to Pittsburgh Penguins game. We're going to be at the trade deadline right there. We're going to have to be able to take a look. Maybe there's some players we can trade for. Goddamn, Buffalgun got injured again. Second time in the season he gets injured. Can you stay in shape, my guy? Because we need all of our players right now. I don't know what's going on. Our players are getting injured. We're getting hit for the first time. I think we didn't have a... Like, we had one injury, and that was the end of the season last year. So, this year, it's definitely different. We're getting hit big time. It's fine, though. It's bound to happen, you know. There's some seasons where some teams get hit a little bit more by with injuries than others. Seems like this year might be our time to get hit big time. Can we get some wins right here? There's a loss against two losses in a row right there. Not good. There we go. There's a 5-0 loss against 5-0 win against the Red Wings. We gotta get some wins going right there, boys. We can't be losing. Shootout loss right there. Okay. Well, once things for sure, as we get a win against Detroit. Yeah, there we go. Once things for sure is we are not gonna get the President's Trophy this year. Not this time around. But we could at least hope to have a good season. We're at the top of our division all of a sudden. There we go. We're at the top of our division, boys. 74 points. 6-3-1 for the last 10 games of record. Malkin is now our best player, 52 points. So I imagine, I guess Lafreniere started to drop a little bit in terms of production. That's fine, I guess. But yeah, as you can see right here, not too shabby, not too shabby. We bounce back up, boys. If we keep playing good, we're gonna make it to the playoffs. We just gotta keep doing our thing, though. We just gotta keep playing good. That's one thing that's for sure. How's the first line? So the first line's connecting. I mean, they've got plus 16, plus 5, plus 8. It's working out. It's just point-wise, they're not producing. They don't get points, point-wise. They're not really getting those things. Lafreniere's second line's doing great. The second line's doing just fine. How many points does he have, Lafreniere? 50 points in 60 games played. I'm still very happy about that. Olofsson. And yeah, the third line's doing great as well. Now, Kako is getting hit big time in terms of production, right? He's got half the points compared to his games. That's only because he's playing on the third line. If he was playing on the first line, he probably would be doing great. But I don't want to risk it, boys. I mean, he doesn't have the poise. That's why he's playing on the third line. If he doesn't have the poise, that means he's not made to play in the first line, I guess. Teravainen, how's the fourth line? Fourth line's doing just fine as well. Yeah, I like to see that. I like to see that quite a lot. We got all these guys right here doing just fine as it is, it looks like. And goalie-wise, Shesterkin is doing great as usual. And Obi's going up. He's going up in terms of production. Do we have any players that grew up right there? Not really. Still have Simmons at 81 overall. Nah, we're good. It looks like, yeah, we don't have anybody per se in the minors that we should probably bring up or anything. What we're going to do is we're going to do our due diligence, see if there's any players, of course, like always, that we could possibly trade or something. Let's take a look, boys, really quick. So any players on our team that have a high value that are below 85 or are at, yeah, below 85, basically. So Trouba's 85, I'm keeping him. There's these guys. No, I'm keeping them. Okay, so what about... no, that's 88. Malkin, I'm keeping him. I'm good on that part. So, seems like the only real option would be probably Strom. Let me see really quick. There we go. Let's go into the 84s right here. So, anybody whatsoever after that probably falls apart. Yeah, it falls apart big time. So, the only options... Probably possible options would be Ryan Strom. We could try and trade him away, boys. Yeah, we could trade him away. He's got 1 year left as well of contract. We've got Kendre Miller. Now, there's a little bit of a prospect D-man. I am going to keep him because he's growing. So I think the only option right here we have is Ryan Strom. We could try and trade Ryan Strom for a better center. Just like we did last time with Malkin, right? Went for a better center for Malkin. Maybe we could get lucky. Maybe get Crosby this time around. I don't know. Let's find out really quick if we can't get a good center or something. What is Ryan Strom? Is he a playmaker? I think he is, right? I think he's a playmaker. So you guys already know I want to go for either a playmaker or a sniper. It's as simple as that. And since he's a playmaker... I might as well just go for a playmaker again, boys. I'm just going to go overall, but we'll try and see what's the best option right here is, boys. So I obviously want to go as well for a player that knows what he's doing, you know. So I want to go for forwards and first line. Let's go for... Actually, any really. Just go for any lines. The only thing is, I just want to look. There we go. Let me scout ahead really quick, though. All right, I think I found my guy, boys. I think we're going to go for Backstrom right here. We're going to try and get Backstrom. He's 36 years of age. He's going to drop, obviously, like Malkin. But he's just there to be a veteran a veteran player, and he's better right now. What we need is a right now player. I don't care about growing players. I just want players that are here right now, helping us out. He's got 2 years left of contract. We don't have a salary cap on, so we can do whatever we want, all right? So he's 87 overall, major upgrade. And plus, he's got the playmaker stats as well. And his poise is better than his overall, which is what I'm looking for, boys. So he's got a good poise. Let's go for him. Let's go for him straight up right there. So we're going to ask for him. We're going to go for Washington Capitals. We're going to give them Ryan Strome, 30 years of age, right? He's not a young man anymore, Ryan Strome. He's a veteran. So you get a veteran, 34 years of age. He's doing good for us. He's been doing it for us for a while now. But I think it's going to have to go straight up, boys. Don't think there's any shenanigans here. It's just going to have to literally go straight up right here. Rejected. Okay, so we're probably going to have to give them something. We're going to have to give them something in exchange. Anything, really. Maybe a bit of a prospect or anything, really. A couple of prospects right there, like that, for example. That should work. There we go. So three random prospects that I'm never going to sign anyways. And Ryan Strome for Nicholas Backstrom, boys. So there it is. We got an upgrade for this year for Backstrom. So that's great. He's going to be able to play on the second line for us. He's not eligible for the first line compared to Malkin. So he's going to play on the second line. It's as simple as that, boys. Just a simple equation right there. So, Backstrom, you're going in there. There we go. You're going in there, buddy. And you're going to be playing with Lafreniere, who grew to an 89 overall, boys. Just like that. Good. Good for him. He's growing. So, there we go. So, Backstrom with Lafreniere and Rackel. That's how it's going to go, boys. As simple as that. Just like that. And let's hope that everything's working out. Maybe if we do that. That's not going to change anything. Nope. So I'll just keep it like that for now. Now it's three playmakers playing together. So this is why the second line might be struggling in terms of production. I don't know. But I feel like we did good right here. So we got Backstrom. That's the only option we have, to be honest. So we don't have any other options. I don't need to do anything. The only trade that we could have possibly done, and we did it. So... We're gonna move past the trade deadline, and we'll see if there's any big time trades that happen. Probably, boys. It's highly likely that it did happen. So, just take a look really quick. Let's get past the four first games after the trade we did for Ryan Strome, Nicholas Backstrom, brand new in our team, boys. What can he do for us? We got a win against Pittsburgh, a win against Edmonton. There we go. Another win against the Los Angeles Kings. I'm going to go buyer. I'm going to skip the entire thing. Continue simming. And a win against Anaheim Ducks as well. So we go in with a little bit of a winning streak. We're at 5 games in a row right here. 5 wins in a row. And 4 wins in a row ever since we got Backstrom as well. So telling you, boys, getting these quick upgrades right here, that's all you need. Let's find out right here. Is there any trades that major trades or anything that happened while we were simulating? Well, straight off the bat, we can already see one of the major trades. The Panthers are going to get Enze Kopitar and Lekkonen for a second round pick and a third round pick. Really? Kopitar must have dropped big time for being traded for a second round pick, boys. That's interesting. Tyler Pertuzzi, nothing really. Jake Gardiner, first round pick. Beauvillier, Zaitsev. Trying to see right here. Calgary Flames are going to get their hands on Bergeron, Edmondson, and Mangiapane for the bank for a couple of draft picks. Okay. Chris Letang, boys, going to Calgary. Calgary is getting these veterans right now. Kapanen as well going there. Bo Bennett, I guess, or Sam Bennett, I guess. That's about it. Aside from that, I'd say the biggest trade was Kopitar. But then again, I think mine might be the biggest one by far. So let's keep it going. Let's keep the simulation going, boys. We're doing great right now. We don't want to miss anything up. So 4, 6, 8, and 10, I believe. So all the way up to the Buffalo Sabres game right here. Let's keep it going, boys. Win these games. Get a little bit of a big-time winning streak going. There we go. That's 6 wins in a row right there, boys. Just like that. 7 in a row. There we go. Keep it going. Buffalo Goon's injured, but we're winning games right now. I'm going to keep it in there. There we go. Keeping it out of there. 9 in a row. Oh, there we go. Okay, so hold on. Okay, well, we might as well simulate onto the Buffalo games, Buffalo Sabres game right there. So we went into a 9-game winning streak. So that's really good. And afterward, we lost, but in shootout. So we got a point. We literally got a point. So the only loss we've got, I think, yeah, 9-0-1, boys, for the last 10 games. That is fantastic. That's fantastic. And actually, we're contendership now for the President's Trophy. I still don't think we're going to get it because the Canucks are well above us. We also have the Maple Leafs who are just above us, the Hurricanes as well, and the Panthers are well above us as well. So I don't think they're going to slow down. And I think we might slow down. So I don't know, boys. Let's get Buffalo Goon back in there. He's back from his injury. Lafreniere got a minor injury going, but he's fine on his part. Brendan Hunt is doing a fine job on the third pair right there. He's doing a really good job at replacing Buffalo Goon. But Buffalo Goon is now an 83 overall, boys. So he's not an 85 anymore. So he's now eligible. He's Giordano dropped as well, by the way. So Giordano dropped. I'm going to keep him in there. But he's forced to play on the third duo now, for sure. So now I got to play either one of these two. So which one will I play? Poise 81 and Poise 85. So I'll just have to play it that way, boys. It's going to have to go like that, I guess. Miller is going to be on the second line right there. So we want to take a look really quick at our team stats. How far did we go up in terms of team stats? Last time we were going up big time. Did we go up to the best team or something, right? Not exactly, but we're the kind of the second best team of our division in terms of offense-wise. And we are the best defensive team as well. So talk about a clear takeover, boys. Now, Rangers-wise power play, it's definitely better than it was in the beginning of the season. So I'm fine with that. And we are at the second best penalty kill. We went from the worst at everything to one of the best at everything, boys. Just like that, switching strategies around in-game. You know, someone might, like Superman might tell you that the strategies, you don't need to change them because it doesn't matter. Because the coaches are the ones who determine the strategies. That is false. That is completely false. The only thing that the coaches are there for is for the chemistry. They're only there for the chemistry, boys. They don't change anything else. I've learned that a long time ago. It's the main thing about this game is the coaches, they change the chemistry of your players, thus remaining their morale. It's affecting their morale, basically. And since there's no morale or anything, we're not using that, it doesn't goddamn matter. Whether the chemistry is good or not, I mean, it determines a little bit, but not too much. Let's take a look at our players right now. Like, what are they doing? Like, see, look at my players. They're doing just fine. 57 points. Lafreniere was doing great. Now, he's slowed down quite a lot because he's playing with two other playmakers, so it's hurting his production. That's what's hurting him, not the chemistry. What's hurting him is the fact that there's two other playmakers with him. That's the only thing that's hurting him. Backstrom, Panarin, everybody's doing great. Everybody's doing just fine. Rackle. Now, Rackle maybe needs a little bit of an upgrade, but he's zero, so he's just fine. There's no minuses that I see right now. All right, here we go. We're good. And talk about Miller. I mean, Miller was like minus 13. He's minus 12, minus 2 now. See? That's what I'm talking about, boys. This is the main difference right here. Main difference. What about, where's my guy right there? Where's Barry? There we go. Barry was minus 17. He's a plus 2 now. So that's the main difference. That is the main difference. By a long shot, boys. Shesterkin playing great for us. No matter what season he is on, he's always going to be playing great for us, boys. So, you know, we don't need to change anything. We just got to keep going. So, like I was saying, basically the main difference here is the strategies. You got to change your strategy if it doesn't work out. It does make a difference, boys. It really does. 2, 4, 6, 8, and... Oh, okay, so hold on. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Okay, yeah. I'm going to just simulate the entire rest of the season, I guess. There's only 12 games remaining. We might as well simulate the rest right here. Lafreniere says it said that he was back, but he was already playing. It was a minor injury. There we go. So there's a loss against Buffalo, but we got two wins in a row right here. A third in a row. There we go. Keep it going. There's a loss. Regulation. 1-0, boys. Could have had some points right there. Come on. There we go. There's an extra point against Boston Bruins. Another extra point against Toronto. But I think these couple of losses there that we got towards the end, I think they're going to hurt our chances big time. Yeah, we're not going to get the President's Trophy with these little losses right here. Even though we get the extra points, it's too many losses, boys. Actually, let's get advance the day because we're not all 82. Yeah, we need to advance the day right here, boys. We're not all 82 right here. There's still some teams that haven't played their entire games. What the hell? How many? There we go. I think everybody played right here. Yeah, all right. So we finished up at 108 points. So best team of our division once again, boys. We went from the worst team of to the best team. 49 goal wins. There we go. There we go. Okay, yeah. We already got defeated. You see that? So we're not going to get the President's Trophy. Maple Leafs, I think they got it. No, actually, they didn't get it. It's the Panthers. The Florida Panthers won the President's Trophy, boys. Best team of the league. 114 points. Good for them. Let's take a look at the actual stats for the player stats. I already knew my team stats are just fine. Best player or best scorer of our team this year was Malkin. 39 goals, boys. He's doing his thing on the first line. He was also our best player, so we didn't have a player that was absolutely a stud this year. We had Malkin, which was point per game. We was just fine. The other ones, I don't know, boys. For Lafreniere and Panarin, Lafreniere had a great season, a better season than I expected. Panarin, a disappointing season. Another disappointing season for Panarin, boys. So, oh well, I guess kind of starting to drop a little bit in terms of production. That's not good, boys. Lafreniere he did great. He had his best season of his career so far, boys. Finally, I think he's starting to, because his overall is going up, he's starting to actually produce, doing stuff properly, right? And that's only going to help him out in the long run. The one thing that's kind of bad for us is Kako, right? I really missed the part. Like he could be a great stud for us if I would play him the first line, make him grow. The problem is I can't do that because I gotta trust in the system of the game. In the system of the game, it works in a weird way, boys. So I don't have a choice but to put Kako in that tier, I guess, in that weird tier where he's on par with the 84s and stuff, right? So it is what it is. Maybe next year, if he continues to grow, he's going to be an 88 or an 89, just like Lafreniere. Then he's going to be a guaranteed first liner. But right now, it's just not the case. He just can't play that. All right. So Tyson Barry, weaker season than last year. But that's only because he played most of his season in the second and then in the third line or third pair. So it's a great season for him in those perspective. And everybody else did pretty good. Boudin had a pretty good season for the first season, right? Fourth line the entire time. He had 18 goals, boys, on the fourth line. 23 points. This guy is an absolute stud. He's a monster in terms of goals. He scores goals. He's definitely a sniper big time. And goalies, we've got Shesterkin, 36 wins. And 916 save percentage, 901 save percentage for Olby. Went back up. That's good for him. Let's take a look at the entire league now for the stats and all. So, entire league. Best score of the league. There we go. Ovechkin, boys. So, Ovechkin's got the most goals. 52 goals at 38 years of age, boys. He still got it. And afterwards, it's Tarasenko. Nobody else got the 450s. Best player of the league was Matthews at 99 points. So not a single player who had the 100. Close to it, but no one. Pedersen, 89. Kuznetsov, 89, boys. Brock Besser, there we go. Lindholm, Dylan Strome, Ryan's brother, boys. Patrick Kane, Seguin, Fiala, all of these players. Okay, they all got there. That's not what I meant to do. Defensive-wise, best defenseman was not Erik Karlsson this time around. It was, in fact, Dougie Hamilton, 74 points. Ekman Larsson, the other John Karlsson this time around. There you go, Dali. Erik Karlsson went from best to this right here. He had a tough time, it looks like. Yeah, he went from 90 to 78 to 63. He's downgrading. He's like he's doing like Panarin basically. They're both downgrading. That's always a bad thing to see, I guess. Goalie wise, best goalie of the season by far is going to be Frederik Andersen. 47 wins. He's got the best saving percentage as well. We've got Ullmark Demko. Is our goaltender in there? Shesterkin, there we go. I think that's the top 12, right? So he's in the top 12, boys. Good, good, good. I didn't see the prospect, but it doesn't matter too much. All I'm intrigued about right now is the actual playoff, boys. So how are we going to perform in the playoffs? I'm very intrigued. We're going to be facing off against our rivals, the New York Islanders right here. So it's a rivalry team for New York. Rivalry setup for the first round. So let's see what we got against us, up against us in the first round, boys. We're simulating the playoffs in this video as well. So we're going to have a lot of fun. Let's hope that we can win again, once again, the Stanley Cup. But I don't guarantee you, man. It's hard enough to win it once. Twice in a row, kind of impossible. I don't know. DeBrusk, Barzell, and Bailey. Nothing too crazy. They got Barzell, but it's nothing crazy. Bellows, Wallstrom, Hosang. Or Oshang, I guess. I don't know. Kopaka, Gergensens, Adam Lee, or Endersley, I guess. Roussel, Carrick, and Deragojinstev. Oh, I'm going to butcher that name. Oof, that's a weird name. All right, so they don't have any depth. But they have some interesting players up front, but not really any depth. So their offense is not really interesting. And defense as well. Yeah, they don't have anything defensively. So they're not really a strong team. They don't have any goaltenders. Yeah, okay. They don't have any goal. They don't have anything. They have nothing, boys. No goaltenders, no defense. And they don't have depth. So, yeah, it's all good. If we can't beat these guys, there's a problem. So let's go, boys. There's a problem if we can't beat these guys. We got to be able to beat them up big time. We should be able to dominate them, literally. So let's dominate them. This should not be a problem. Power play for us. We can't score in the power play. They get a goal. And 5-on-5 by Bellows. That is not good. There we go. Olofsson's going to score a goal for us. There we go, boys. Do your thing. There we go. Kasha. There's a goal on first line, boys. First line producing for us. We got to get... Yeah, there we go. This is what I like to see. Lafreniere on the second line producing for us. There we go. There's a goal. This is what I'm expecting right here. I don't expect the Islanders to give us any trouble. Penalty kill. They're going to score right after it. So they got a little bit of a momentum shift. They scored a goal out of that. Kopaska got a goal for them. They got a momentum shift big time from that, boys. That's not good. They're actually outplaying us right now. There we go. Getting momentum back into our hands. Panarin's going to get a goal right here. See, that's the main difference. We got a goalie and they don't. They don't have any goalies, so we can score at ease right here. Johansson's going to score. There we go. Campbell's garbage. He's an 80 overall goaltender. Kaapo Kakko. There it is. A goal for him. You're going to be able to score at ease, boys. It's not even going to be a like a problem for us. It's not going to be a problem at all. This is easy. There we go. Seventh goal of the game. And Boudin, boys, his first goal of the playoffs in his career right here. There it is. First game, first goal for him. Fantastic. All right. Well, that was an easy one. 7-1, 7-2, boys. Easy win right there. Let's just hop on into the next one, next game. We're going to dominate these Islanders. They've got nothing on us. They literally have nothing. Well, first shot, first goal, DeBrusk. I'm talking shit. This is what happens, boys. Shesterkin, keep it together, my guy. What the hell? You can't be giving goals like that. Okay, Barzell's going to score. So it looks like their first line is going to show up in this game, I guess. Even though we're dominating them once again. Let's go, boys. Let's score some goals right here. But there's no way, like, we shouldn't be struggling against this team. This team's got nothing. They got no defense. They got no goaltending. They've got the first line, but that's about it. I mean, oh my God. And okay, Roussel's going. This is over, boys. We lost that game. We lost that game big time. There we go. Malkin giving us a goal in the first line, boys. I don't know what we were doing in this game, boys. I don't know what was going on. Are we okay right here? We're dominating them. How are we losing right now? We can't score 3 goals on them? They've got Campbell in the net. Hey, an 80 overall goaltender, boys. The fuck? He's playing out of his mind right now. 30 shots? What the hell, boys? All right. It's going to be one of these weird ones. Yeah, okay. So this is one of these weird ones. Whatever, it's a best of 3, so I guess we're going to the last game right here. They better not beat us, boys, I swear. We literally won 7-2 in the first game. Like, come the fuck on right here. Let's go, boys. Gotta defeat these guys. Oh, my first shot, first goal again. Shesterkin, I'm gonna fucking kill you. What are you doing, buddy? What is wrong with you? DeBrusque again. Oh my God, we're getting out. Oh my, yeah, go ahead. Go ahead, EA. Go, yeah. Pile it on, EA. Have fun. Have fucking fun. Why not? Oh my God, this is garbage. I'm getting fucking trolled. What a garbage simulation right here. I'm getting trolled, boys. What the living hell is going on here? Power play, we can't score a goal. They get 4 goals unanswered right away on the first period. What is this? They don't have anything. They don't even have a team. I'm facing up against an AHL team and I'm losing 5-1. What is going on? Am I not the defending Stanley Cup champions? Holy shit, boys. This is ridiculous. Guys, would you mind showing up or something? What is this? Oh my, okay. I'm done. I'm fucking done, boys. This is crazy. I'm fucking getting... Okay. Oh my God. 7-1. Can we stop this? Please just stop the massacre, man. Oh, thank you, Rackle, for showing up at fucking 1 minute left of the last period. I can't do this, boys. We just got eliminated by a garbage team in the first round. Got handled by him as well. What the fuck? And the Avalanche are going to win the cup, boys. So Colorado wins the cup. That's good for them, I guess. This is garble. This is absolutely garble. I don't even understand what just happened right there. There we go. Forwards, Patrick Marleau. Looks like every single St. Jose Sharks franchise player decided to finish their career with Montreal for some reason. Marleau finished with Montreal. 1329 points. Good for him. Spezza, boys. There we go. Finishing in the minors. 1,000 points, boys. There we go. In his career. Parise, Krejci, Brown, Bobby Ryan, Carter, Gagne. A bunch of players like these. Defenseman-wise, we got Brent Burns. Finishing off his career with the Detroit Red Wings right here. Yendol, Goligoski, Vlasic, Johnson, Hjalmarsson. So I got a couple of players, boys. A couple of players, big-time veterans, legendary players taking their retirement. There's another one, Lundqvist, with the Pittsburgh Penguins, taking his retirement, boys. At 530 wins, though. That might be the third best record, right? That's really close to Patrick Roy's record. So that's interesting. He might be the second or the third best goaltender of all time right there with that record. Pekka Rene, Miller right here. So really a lot of veterans, boys. A lot of legendary veterans going up to their retirement after that year. So we lost Sam Gagne in the minors, I guess. And who else? Nobody else. Okay. Yeah, I don't know what happened there. It started off really strong. It started off like it made sense because we were dominating the other team, right? We dominated the Islanders 7-2 in the first game. That made sense. They had nothing. But then we went on to lose. Okay, I said maybe. All right, that's normal, I guess. One game when the first line shows up, fine, I guess. The last game, though, the third game, that made no fucking sense. We got handled 7-2. That did not make sense, man. I don't know where Shesterkin was. I don't know where my players were. I don't know. Maybe we drank too much before the night or something. I have no idea what just happened, but I guess it's part of EA. EA voodooing me big time. I'm telling you, boys, it's impossible to win two cups in a row. Winning one cup is hard enough. Winning two in a row? Shit, man. This is something else entirely. All right, so I'll leave it for right now, boys. You already know what's the deal. What the deal is. The next video, we're going to do the draft lottery. We're going to do this free agency, everything. And maybe simulate a little bit of the season. I'm not sure. We'll see, though. Remember to leave a like, subscribe, and enjoy this video. See you guys for the next one. Keep it easy.